take center stage. Their goal? Making sure Seth Greenberg and South Florida don't return tomorrow. Kelly Tires is proud to present the 2003 Conference USA Men's Basketball Tournament. From Freedom Hall in Louisville, Kentucky, it's the number 2 seed Memphis Tigers against the Bulls of South Florida. The Bulls with the upset yesterday, opening up the tournament, knocking off the 7th seed DePaul 76-74. Hi, everybody, alongside Reed Geddes. I'm Mike Gleason. It's great to have you on board. And Reed, you look at Conference USA, Dwayne Wade of Marquette wins Player of the Year. But I got to tell you, Chris Massey's probably playing as well as anyone at this point. He's an almost automatic double-double.
Yeah, these two teams split during the regular season, and Chris Massey was an absolute monster in both games. And, you know, Dwayne Wade won Player of the Year. But you've got to wonder, with numbers like that, if Chris Massey had not missed the first 7 games, would that vote have been different yesterday?
Good point. Jimmy Baxter stepped up, the world-class leaper for South Florida yesterday, contributed 14 points, 11 rebounds. John Rooney, Ed Pinckney have the call on the other side. Enjoy the first half. See you back here at halftime. Today's Conference USA game is brought to you by Kelly Tires, a good deal on a great tire. Phillips 66. We put the best in our super clean gasolines so you get the most out of your car. Think smart. Think performance. Think Phillips 66. AT&T Wireless. AT&T Wireless brings you M-Life, your mobile life made better. And by Infiniti, makers of innovative high-performance premium vehicles.
Not quite a stop sign. Yet not a matter to be taken lightly either. No problem. You've come prepared. Plenty of stopping power. And plenty of get up and go. Kelly Tires. A good deal on a great tire. Call 866-90-KELLY.
Introducing Intel Centrino Mobile Technology. The new wireless laptop technology designed to help you unwire your life. It's your chance to untangle, unburden, uncomplicate, and unwire. Intel Centrino Mobile Technology.
We know that you guys don't have any of these on the menu, like a, you know, good tasting breakfast sandwich.
So we brought you a Sonic Breakfast Toaster sandwich as like a, you know, a gift.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Enjoy. Be well.
Thank you very much. Bye.
Thanks a lot.
Oh, that felt good.
Better breakfast. Sonic's got it. The others don't. Introducing Sonic Breakfast, featuring breakfast toaster sandwiches, big breakfast burritos, pancake on a stick, and more. Sonic Breakfast. Have a good morning.
In the spring of 1903, Henry Ford made the automobile affordable for everyone. The same holds true today, especially now during Ford's Centennial Celebration Savings Event. Get 0.9% financing for 60 months on Ford Explorer. 0.9 for 60 months saves you over $6,000 in finance charges. That's over $6,000 in savings on the best-selling SUV in the world. Savings Henry Ford himself would be proud of. See your local Ford dealer today.
Freedom Hall in Louisville, Kentucky. Number 10 seed South Florida against number 2 seed Memphis. And now let's take a look at the Intel starting lineups. Will McDonald at 15.9 points a game is the leading scorer for South Florida. We talked about Chris Massie in the open. Antonio Burks is third in Conference USA assists. 5.64 a game. And the assist leader, of course, number 35 for South Florida, Reggie Cohn. Reggie Cohn was dangerous from three-point range in yesterday's win over DePaul. The officials, as assigned by Conference USA, Tom O'Neill, Hal Lusk, and J.B. Caldwell, we're set for basketball today. Round 2 of the Conference USA tournament presented by Kelly Tires. How about the matchup today, Ed?
I cannot wait for this one. You got two of the better big men in Conference USA in Will McDonald and Chris Massie. You're going to really see textbook inside play by both these two big guys.
Reggie Cohn has his hands on the basketball. Here we go. Terrence Leather out high for Will McDonald. Reggie Cohn and Antonio Burks draws that assignment defensively. Inside, there's McDonald, and he couldn't close the deal, but Leather follows, and he misses. Earl Barron rebounds for Memphis.
Well, you see how intense it is already on the inside. Both guys going at it.
Here's Barron out high. In the scramble, Memphis with the ball. Nice play by Massie, and the jumper by Burks won't go. Yusuf Baker with the board for South Florida. Baxter all the way in and lost the ball at the end line.
Yeah, expect the first couple of minutes to be this way. I think you could honestly say that there's a genuine dislike by both these teams against one another. They split the season series, each team winning on each other's home court. Both feeling that as though they can win this ball game today.
0-0, 18:51 and counting in the first half. We're just underway, and Cohn got a hand on the ball, denying the entry pass to Massie. Here's Baxter off the fake, and McDonald. Baxter with the assist, and Will McDonald makes it 2-0 South Florida.
Well, great net recognition by Cohn already early in the ball game. South Florida trying to get out and run, get some easy baskets. Very close to being backcourt.
And maybe a double dribble the way
wow.
That was handled. But Tom O'Neill right there said no problem with it. Carney with the entry pass for Massie. And saved by Anthony Rice. Carney from the baseline. A three ball.
I want to tell you what, he has really come on towards the latter part of the season. He is really shooting the long ball very well.
Averaging 9.7 a game, and he made the Conference USA All-Freshman team, Rodney Carney. McDonald against Barron.
Wow.
Off the glass. A beautiful shot.
I'll tell you what, he made some great decisions towards the latter part of the game just the other day against DePaul, and he is right on track early on here.
Ed Salfoda made sure Will McDonald had the ball late in the game. I thought that was a key to victory.
It really was. He made great decisions. He found a lot of weak side play from the weak side. They were able to score in some easy layups, and when that wasn't open, they found the three-point shot by Cohn.
Reggie Cohn was trying to get the ball into Will McDonald, but that bounced off Anthony Rice. Now let's check the Kelly Tires road to the championship.
We'll take a look at it right at the top. Stay on the glass for South Florida. Keep going. Cohn going offensively. He had a big night just yesterday from the three-point line. Make good post decisions, and that's what McDonald did yesterday.
The pass for Baxter. Oh, beautiful move to the basket.
I'll tell you what, you know, he gets better as the season goes on. Different facets of the game. I thought earlier during the season he drove to the basket very well, but the outside shot really coming along.
He's one of their best defenders now that Marlon Bryant, top of the season, injured a knee at Marquette. Memphis. With Massie scoring, he has 2 points. A 6-5 South Florida lead. But Jimmy Baxter has played basketball all along. What, his sophomore, junior year of high school?
Absolutely has been a... He's a two-sport athlete. High jump champ, in fact, would like to go out for the 2004 Olympics. That was a possibility for him.
Reggie Cohn contested, and this goes out of bounds off Baxter. Cohn is out of control and threw the ball off his teammate. And the Kelly Tigers' road to the championship continues here with the Memphis Tigers.
You take a look at Memphis, and they've got to keep close to Cohn and Baxter in the backcourt. They did a fantastic job offensively just yesterday. Work offensively inside out. That simply means make sure that Massie is involved in the game at all times and then stay tough defensively. Memphis, the Memphis coaching staff really feels as though they were able to go on the streak of 11 wins in a row because of their defense.
McDonald broke up that play, and here come the Bulls, leading 6-5. Rice is in the game along with Richmond for Memphis now. Burks on Reggie Cohn. And a block is called against Antonio Burks, his first foul. Seth Greenberg, his seventh year in South Florida, 108 victories. He has two NIT appearances with the Bulls. And John Calipari, Conference USA Tournament play, 1-2, 70 victories at Memphis, and took his team to the NIT championship last year. A foul, South Florida foul, Memphis with the ball. We have a timeout, 15:57 to go. We're in the first half, just underway from Freedom Hall. The Bulls own a one-point lead over the Memphis Tigers.
Back in 1927, we pumped our first gallon of Phillips 66, and word got around we made pretty good gasoline. Our idea was, treat customers like neighbors, because they are, and make sure that Phillips 66 gasoline is always good enough to keep their cars coming back week after week. It was a good idea 75 years ago, and you know what? It still is. Year after year, mile after mile, and for all the miles to come, Phillips 66.
You're 34, sweetheart. You should be thinking about your future.
Mom, I've been investing.
Oh, please.
I bought EMI.
You bought EMI? You own EMI, the music company? Well, I am so proud of you.
You want a piece of my heart?
Oh, baby.
In the interest of our long-standing commitment to the independent investor, we interrupt our commercial to announce the Ameritrade Switchers Reserve, a pool of $1 million specially earmarked to pay $50 toward the transfer fee of everyone who opens an individual or joint account by April 29, 2003 with a transfer of $10,000 or more. You'll also get 30 commission-free internet equity trades to use over your first 30 days. Get your share today at Ameritrade.com/switch/. Now, back to our commercial. Join the thousands who switch to Ameritrade every month. Ameritrade, what's your share? Switch to Ameritrade today and get $50 plus 30 commission-free internet equity trades.
Well, McDonald has 4 points of the Bulls 6 and a South Florida 1-point lead over Memphis in the first half. For that Pinkney, I'm John Rooney, and we have seen a tentative start to the game today, but I think the two teams are beginning to get into a rhythm now.
Yeah, offensively, they certainly are. Good example, just before the timeout, South Florida really able to execute very well on an out-of-bounds play. They did a fantastic job, and you'll see right here up at the top, they actually have a double screen set for Jimmy Baxter, and he's going to come off the screen and do a great job and use his athleticism to finish off on that play. And those are some of the smaller things that South Florida has used in order to play well in CUSA.
A Terrence Leather foul just before the break, and Memphis on the attack after the timeout. Richmond has been bothered by back spasms in the game. This is Grice with the ball. Nothing in the corner, so back up to Burks. Burks at the point, and there's Richmond with the touch, working against Leather. Five on the shot clock. Grice for three. Nice elevation and a beautiful shot.
They're going to really have to be very active against the zone because Memphis really shoots the long ball very well.
We get a chance to take a look at the other scores around the country. Championship week, courtesy of Ameritrade. While our game continues, South Florida down 8-6 after the three ball by Grice. Here's McDonald. An air ball. And a nice finish by Yusuf Baker.
I'll tell you, that last time, McDonald pretty far away from the post. Look at Burks trying to beat the defense back down court.
Didn't work as Burks went out of control in the lane. The ball goes the other way.
You know, right at the top, we talked about Chris Massie and his ability to average a double-double on the season. And that's the kind of defense that's been played against him all season long. And he has simply come up big for John Calipari's team.
Three turnovers for Memphis. Reggie Cohn indicating the set play in our tie game. Will McDonald against Massie. This is Baker. Reggie Cohn with the putback.
Well, I'll tell you,
he was in the right spot.
Yeah, he's trying to make good on his last run. Had a fantastic shooting outing just the other night.
Reggie Cohn against DePaul, 8 for 12, 7 out of 10 from three-point range as Richmond slashes through the lane and scores.
Boy, zone not giving Memphis any problem at all. They've been able to score on it pretty easily so far.
10 all, and Richmond going for the steal. Richmond has missed the last two games because of back spasms. Games against Houston and UAB, and let's take a look. Looks like the back is fine today.
Well, goes right down the lane. Little jump stop inside, gathers himself. Makes a really nice move. I'll tell you, South Florida's going to have to tighten up the zone.
This is Baxter. Oh, what a spin.
Wow!
And Baker with the follow.
I'll tell you.
Yusuf Baker with the dunk. He averages 4.9 a game, and he has two baskets in the first half.
You know, this is Memphis's first game in this tournament, but right now South Florida looks like the fresher team. This is their second game in 2 days. I mean, right down the lane. This is a nice move by Jimmy Baxter, but Baker coming up with the strong finish.
Burks and Richmond out front. Number five is Jeremy Hunt. 6-0 South Florida on the second chance points early. Richmond a little too strong with that shot. Terrence Leather in the rebound.
That's amazing because Memphis is one of the better rebounding teams in Conference USA. South Florida doing a good job up off the boards.
Are you superstitious?
Yeah, I think you could say that. Used to wear one sock up, one sock down when I played my NBA.
I thought so. And with the Memphis foul on Jeremy Hunt, two shots coming up. Well, Seth Greenberg yesterday with the bus coming to the arena. The bus turns into the fairgrounds, takes the right, but misses the left. So they had to take the circle all the way around to get back to that left-hand turn. That didn't make Seth very happy. So today they're coming to the arena. The busy takes the right. He's ready to take the left. Seth goes, no, take the grand tour just like yesterday. It worked yesterday for the win over DePaul.
I'll tell you.
See if it works today.
He's a man after my own heart. I've got a couple. I won't go into them, but
go ahead. We have time here for the free throw.
Well, I'll just tell you one. Okay. I'll give you one. I don't sit my hat on any kind of chair or bed. I told you it was strange now, but I don't do it.
Well, I don't wear a hat, so I don't have to worry about it.
Can't have the hat on the chair, man. That's bad luck.
13-10 favor the Bulls. Richmond looks for Massie, who's covered well inside, so Burks takes the shot. Tip to Reggie Cohn.
Oh, that's where he got most of his points yesterday, in the fast break. Oh, wow. I'll tell you, South Florida really trying to dominate on the inside. And again, you talk about that genuine dislike between the two teams. There we had Massie and McDonald mixing it up underneath.
McDonald got the whistle. That's his first foul. Two team fouls each way. Memphis has some size inside, and how about that block shot? Oh my, Yusuf Baker.
Wow, got to that quick. Unbelievable. Very active is Baker.
Richmond out, Carney in for Memphis.
That's where you talk about the activity in the zone and covering all your bases. Beautiful closeout by Baker that time.
Shot blocker Garrick Morris, number 20, is in for South Florida. The dimensions of size on the floor for Memphis with Earl Barron and Massie. There's Massie in on Morris. Garrick Morris, Will McDonald fighting for it, and Earl Barron was able to tie it up. The possession arrow gives the ball to Memphis.
I'll tell you what Massie has to go through each and every game in order to score. You see right there just trying to carve out some space. Two defenders come over to alter the shot just a bit.
Massie, one bounce, trying to feed Barron low, and that's broken up. Nice save at the end line by Jimmy Baxter. Well, I thought Massie was going to score that one after he bumped into Garrick Morris to create just enough space to finally get a shot away.
Well, you know, they've got him a little indecisive right now. He's not sure whether or not to pass the ball and score. And against a great post offensive player like Massie, that's all you really need to throw his game off just a bit.
I'll tell you, that was some talent by Cone to alter the shot in midair and still get it down. Massie with a spin toward the basket,
wow.
And that goes in for him.
Wow. Well, that throws that theory out of the window.
He needs about that much space.
Massie says no way, and then McDonald right back at him.
McDonald says way.
Yeah, see, I love this. Just the battle of the big guys.
A 17-12 lead for the South Florida Bulls. 11.5 to go in the first half from Louisville, Kentucky. Bullet pass inside for Massie. All bottoms.
Wow. I'll tell you, we've been talking about the big guys right at the top. But Cone not picked on any of the Conference USA teams this season. Really wants to come out and prove something, and he has.
Garrick Morris got caught flat-footed and picked up his first foul. Memphis ball after the timeout. And what hustle in the first half and the intensity. What you would expect from a postseason tournament. The Bulls are leading the Tigers 17-14 in the first half.
Two world-class athletes battle for the first time ever. Kurt Angle, Brock Lesnar. The WWE Championship.
WrestleMania comes early. It's Lesnar and Angle for the WWE title.
Thursday on UPN 30.
Hollywood Casino has now beaten the Tunica Market payout average 4 years running. Hollywood Casino, your place to shine.
The thing about being the basketball coach here at the University of Memphis, it just carries a different kind of weight. You can walk into boardrooms, you can walk into gymnasiums, and have the ability to bring people together in this job. So I understand my job is to coach, to mold young men, to win basketball games, to get those young men educated. And if I do that, I'll have the ability to move this community together and do things as the basketball coach.
I don't know where we're going to get the money to redo the kitchen.
Or to send Andrew to college.
These bills.
Did you hear that?
What was that?
Get the money out of your house with a home equity loan from First Tennessee. You could even get a tax deduction. How scary is that?
With 11-10 to go in the first half in Louisville, Kentucky, the Conference USA tournament. McDonald against Massie in the first half. With Will McDonald scoring 6. Massie has 6. 3-1. Massie has the edge on the board.
Yeah, so far, both those guys really battling on the inside. Very many times, I think the key to post offense is making sure you've got good position and you're close on that block. And that last time down court, Massie said, you know what? I'm struggling a little bit from the left side. Instead of going from the left side, I'll change over to the right. He immediately gets the quick score.
South Florida is out rebounding Memphis, 8-7 in the early going. Memphis has turned over the ball 4 times, 2 for the Bulls. And the jump shot for 3, no good. Anthony Rice on the miss, and here's Reggie Cone.
You know, so far we talk about the keys to the game right up at the top, but so far for Memphis, it's worked. The inside-out play, playing well. Same holds true for South Florida.
Danny Oglesby in the game, touching the ball now. Reggie Cone out front, 12 on the shot clock. And a foul, a hold called against Memphis. And that's on Grice, his first.
You take a look at this last play. Shot clock running down, and Morris just trying to clear out and get the inside position. And South Florida does a really good job when the shot clock is running down. They go into their pick and roll action. They got good action out of it last night against DePaul.
Number three, Brian Swift at the point, a sophomore from Warrensville, Ohio. Eric Morris giving it right back to Swift. Antonio Burks is guarding Swift out of the Memphis man-to-man.
How about Burks? Burks was another guy not picked pretty high on that Conference USA, either the first team or the second team. He has one of the top assist-to-turnover ratios in the league. So he wants to come out here and prove that he is worthy as well as Cone.
Danny Oglesby hits the first Bulls three-pointer of the day. A six-point lead. Rice driving. And in heavy traffic, earns a trip to the free throw line. Garrick Morris has two fouls. 14 fouls on the Bulls, three for the Tigers. Anthony Rice and company. They're going to play the ball in. No shooting foul.
Wow.
I thought that was a shooting foul for sure.
Unbelievable. What else was he doing?
He wasn't walking to the arena. That's
sure wasn't.
They'll play it in. Hunt from the three-point line. Massie. Rice for three. Missed on the straight-on shot.
Oh, I thought that was going to go down. Had his feet set. Good kick out by Massie.
Yusuf Baker has four first-half rebounds. And Massie is called for the foul, bumping into Will McDonald. The first foul on Chris Massie.
And the way that the game has been going, the fans object to the call on the inside. Come on, let the big guys battle on the inside, but that time maybe Massie with a little bit of the arm in the back of McDonald.
Yeah, but you see that every time down here.
Yeah.
Brian Swift inbound for South Florida, 14 fouls each way.
Sure to see more of it as well.
I think you're right.
You know, Massie won't give up the post that easy to McDonald. They switch now defensively, assignments underneath.
Terrence Leather. Knees blocked. Earl Barron said, not this time.
This is not a game to bring the weak stuff, especially on the inside. You got to bring your A stuff on that block.
You were saying on the steal by McDonald, Leather. And his shot was rejected, but Leather driving. Definitely earns a trip to the free throw line this time.
He was grabbed on the way up. But right here, good look up court. Gets Leather right in stride, unable to finish off on the play. But again, South Florida up and into the fast break. That drive around the arena.
Yeah. Looks good right now, doesn't it?
I got to keep that going.
Leather is on the scoreboard in a 21-14 Bulls lead. The foul, by the way, committed by Jeremy Hunt, his second. Five team fouls on the Tigers. Massie with the one-hand rebound. Massie inside from the double team. Just shot that one over the hoop. Earl Barron will be on the free throw line.
And that's another reason why this is one of the better rebounding teams in Conference USA. Massie draws such a crowd. Watch when he gets the ball. One, two, three South Florida players surrounding him. And that leaves the weak side wide open.
Yusuf Becker with the foul is first. Barron, an 82% shooter.
Smooth-looking stroke, I'll tell you.
Leather out, Baxter in for South Florida. Coach Calipari on the sideline, third year at Memphis with 70 victories. Memphis has earned three straight 20-win seasons.
He's working hard on that sideline. His Memphis Tigers ranked 16th in some of the polls. Just dropped in there.
His Memphis Tigers went to the NIT last year. Kelly Wise was unable to play in this tournament, and Memphis lost a second-round game to Houston.
You know, it's really amazing that they've been able to string 11 straight in a row. They've had so many injuries throughout the season. Just Barron, Burks, Massie missing seven games. Richmond out with nine. Hunt with 10 games. I mean, this guy's had a ton of injuries to his ball club, but he's kept everyone very focused.
Massie and Carney would not allow Baker to get to the basket. 32 on the shot clock as South Florida plays it in. McDonald facing Barron.
Wow. They want travel. Boy, the Memphis faithful behind the bench, they are going absolutely bananas.
Now 10 on the shot clock. The ball is kicked. That means a brand new shot clock, and South Florida will have the ball when we come back from a timeout. The Bulls enjoy a 21-15 lead over Memphis.
Nice shot. All day.
You reach?
I teach.
Bet you won't score again.
I won't score again? Hey, like that rainbow. That's ugly.
Could have dunked.
You should have dunked.
Hey, Mike.
What?
Who's got next?
I think this is the one. It's beautiful.
So, you're going to wear white after all. Just kidding, you crazy chick. Weddings are great, and they get better every time.
Who is that?
Vegas.
That's right, baby. Round up the girls, kick up your heels, and party like you still got daddy's credit card.
My lips are sealed.
Hello? Mama's got a hobby. Oh, boy.
Not quite a stop sign. Yet not a matter to be taken lightly, either. No problem. You've come prepared. Plenty of stopping power. And plenty of get up and go. Kelly Tires. A good deal on a great tire. Call 866-90-KELLY.
Update from Chicago, Big Ten Tournament, Ohio State, Iowa. Sean Conley steps outside, knocks down a three. These two teams met in the finals last year, and right now the Buckeyes leading Iowa and Chicago. Let's go back downstairs to John and Ed. Okay, Mike, thank you very much, and we'll check in with you at halftime along with Reed Geddes on our halftime report in Studio 66. This is the Conference USA Men's Basketball Championship presented by Kelly Tires, and a good one going today with South Florida, the number 10 seed, leading Memphis, the number 2 seed, 21-15, inside 8 minutes to go until halftime.
I'll tell you, it's been amazing. You know, the lower seeds have really played very well. How about the 12 seed beating the 5 seed last night? Southern Miss coming up with a huge upset of Cincinnati.
Southern Miss getting a follow shot by Jasper Johnson in the final seconds. And Will McDonald, rejection inside. A simple message for Antonio Burks. What you were talking a while ago, Ed, don't come in here with the weak stuff today.
No, it's absolutely got to be the A game tonight, today.
With Ed Pinckney, I'm John Rooney from Freedom Hall. Memphis on the attack, down 21-15. Reggie Cone near steal. Memphis looked on yesterday as DePaul lost to South Florida. Reggie Cohn trying to stay active. Massie can't score. Hands, arms, legs everywhere in the way of Massie in the lane.
Yeah, you just simply have to have full coverage on Massie. I mean, he does a good job of corralling the ball eventually and drawing that foul. You see Cohn trying to come down on the double team and dig that ball out of Massey's hands.
Massie has scored 7. He doesn't rank in the conference scoring or rebounds or the statistics because he's just shy of 75% of the team's games. He's getting close, though, to earning. He'd be the number 2 rebounder in the conference behind Truscott.
No question.
And he becomes eligible.
I mean, anytime you talk about the top of anyone's scouting report against Memphis, you know, many of the bullet points include Massie.
Barron with the loose ball from Memphis. We're down to 7 minutes to go. Rice slashing into the lane, and he draws contact.
Well, at the top, we talked about the battle of the big guys, and on the side for Memphis, it has been Chris Massie just beating triple teams, double teams. He's had a couple of kickouts for some three-point shots, and I'll tell you, a lot more successful so far on the right side as opposed to the left side, which is where he likes to do most of his damage.
Good observation. Anthony Rice closes the gap to 21-17. Anthony's a 61% shooter who averages 9.3 points a game. One more free throw for Anthony Rice, a sophomore from Atlanta, Georgia. And tapped out to Massie. Here's Massie off the bounce. Burks for Memphis.
Got to get a handle of the offensive rebounding. Memphis getting a couple of opportunities at it.
Rice, that's a three ball.
And that's what usually happens. You give a team as good as Memphis a couple of different looks, they're going to come up with something big.
6:44 to go in the first half of the one-point game, and J.B. Caldwell had a word with Earl Barron about the contact inside, perhaps explaining why they're not blowing the whistle or what they will be blowing the whistle if they see again.
Absolutely. And this thing can, you don't want it to escalate to anything more than it already is. It's very physical on the inside.
A kickball, new 35-second shot clock for Seth Greenberg and South Florida. Reggie Cohn will inbound. Seth Greenberg, a graduate of Fairleigh Dickinson, broadcast journalism major.
Very good, I'll tell you. Hear him very often down in South Florida, in Miami.
Here's Will McDonald. Off the back iron to Billy Richmond. Traveling.
Yes.
Traveling. Burks just couldn't get his balance.
Well, Burks wants to beat Cohn down court, and so far Cohn's done a nice job of tracking back on the defensive end.
30-second timeout taken by South Florida. And coming up after our game, UAB against Louisville. Louisville, the number 16 team in the nation. And that's quarterfinal action in the Conference USA tournament. We hope you'll stay tuned.
I know you did that game last night. How hard did UAB play? I mean, it was unbelievable, the defense that they played last night.
UAB had as good a second half as I've seen in first-round conference tournament action ever. And playing the 40 minutes of tough, rugged basketball on both ends, even with the 20-point lead, they kept the pressure on.
Yeah, absolutely. It's unbelievable.
Coach Anderson's done a very good job there, and Nolan Richardson was in the stands last night cheering on his former assistant coach and recruiting coordinator at Arkansas. And I think Coach Anderson's going to do a fine job there, and he has so far in his first year.
Yeah, he really has. I'll tell you, that backcourt, simply fantastic for UAB. That's a tough angle to try to get the ball inside.
Especially with a pass right at somebody's feet. Yeah. The kick ball, new 35-second clock, 6:03 to go in the first half. Reggie Cohn has 4 points. Yesterday, he made 7 3-point field goals in a 23-point effort. Good pass to McDonald, and he's able to finish on the second try.
I'll tell you, the Cohn was one off the record by Diego Guerrero. He had, I believe it was 8 threes in a game back in 2000 Conference USA play.
Terrence Leather for South Florida. South Florida looking to add to a 3-point lead. Here's Baxter.
Oh, nice dump down.
Slapped out to Antonio Burks. Burks streaking past Cohn. Leather fouls him, and Burks scores anyway.
Boy, he finally got daylight. He's been looking for that all game long. EP2, South Florida defenders back. I mean, just look at this. Right around Cohn and gets the N1. Beautiful body control on his way to the hoop.
Baxter with the foul. His second, and Burks to the free throw line.
I mean, he does that over the top of Baxter. Baxter's got superb vertical. And he really had to get the great body control in order to get that up over the top of Baxter.
What a difficult shot, and that wasn't easy. Burks has scored 3 in the first half. We're tied at 23.
Back and forth we go.
great feed by Cone.
Boy, he knows, McDonald knows that he's got to come up with those.
Carney scores the three, has two of those in the first half, and that has to hurt South Florida. Missed dunk on one end and a three-pointer on the other.
Well, you simply don't want to compound a miss and allow the Memphis to come up with the make on the other end.
A blocking foul is called against Antonio Burks, his second. And our Ameritrade scoreboard will give you the action going on around the country and the other conference tournaments. And we'll be checking that throughout the day. Keep an eye on your screen. Ameritrade scoreboard. Let's take a look at a missed dunk.
This is a slip right off the screen, and McDonald does everything right except for finish on the play. And look at the reaction by Greenberg. He knows that should have been two.
Earl Barron may have contested that to the point where McDonald couldn't go ahead and finish it, but that was a missed opportunity. Here's Leather.
Well, I'll tell you, Cone just lays the passes right on the money. What a beautiful feed by Cone inside to Leather.
He's the Conference USA assist leader. He's made some beautiful passes today and should have more assists than he does. Three or four more of missed opportunities have taken those away from him. Two assists so far for Reggie. Clyde Wade is in the game. Carney looks for Wade, finds him on the sideline.
Boy, that weak side, I'll tell you, you got to stay really active on that weak side. South Florida just loaded up on Massie.
Earl Barron to Carney after Barron got the offensive board. 28-25 Memphis.
That's going to be available again. The defense loading up on Massie.
Reggie Cone for three. The follow's no good for McDonald. There's Massie at the end line for Memphis. Cone favoring his right elbow as he hit the court after missing the three-point attempt.
I'll tell you, he's battled injuries all season long, had problems with his shins, and Seth Greenberg, during most parts of the season, had to regulate some of his time in practice.
Here's Barron with a one-hand shot. Jimmy Baxter. Cone last year didn't practice. He rode the exercise bike and then played in the games because of leg problems.
Well, very often you can catch him at least an hour and a half to 2 hours before each and every game just working on his outside shot.
McDonald is fouled by Barron, the first on Earl. And it's not that Cone didn't want to practice. He just couldn't because of injuries last year.
Well, they actually think he's not going to be able to play basketball after he finishes up this season. So he's going pretty hard at it. And you see just that last play, the creativity of Cone.
Will McDonald on the line. McDonald has scored 8 points in the first half.
Yeah, he's causing havoc underneath, but he's just been unable to come up with a lot of finishes. But I can't talk enough about how McDonald finished off last night's game against DePaul. South Florida had 12 opportunities down the stretch, and he came up with 11 of the 12 finishes.
Here's Earl Barron taking advantage of an opportunity. Offensive rebound and a stuff by Carney. The Tigers lead by two.
Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on.
It's Toyota's nationwide spring sales event, where value begins with an all-star lineup of quality Toyota cars. And now, Toyota has just announced 0% financing on Camry. That's 0% financing on one of the most dependable cars ever. That's 0% that could save you up to $2,200 on Camry. But it's only for a limited time. During Toyota's nationwide spring sales event at Covington Pike, Chuck Hutton, or Performance Toyota now.
Hey folks, Mike Bowen for Champion Awards. Since 1970, Champion has provided trophies, plaques, and recognition products to the Mid-South. Champion is also the largest t-shirt printer in Memphis, but no order is ever too small. Also, our embroidery department can supply all of your corporate apparel. Champion can provide over 50,000 promotional products for businesses, schools, or churches. Please call our customer service department at 365-4830 today. As always, I thank you for your business.
You're a great mom. You're beautiful and you're smart and you work so hard.
Billy, would you like me to call your mom and see if you can stay for dinner?
If you insist.
Introducing the Cinemeal Deal. Any large Pizza Hut pizza, America's favorite, with up to three toppings, just $11.99. Plus a generous order of our new freshly baked cinnamon sticks absolutely free. The $11.99 Cinemeal Deal. Spoil your family, not your budget.
You're powerful, smart.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
At Pizza Hut.
ESPN Plus coverage, Kelly Tires. A good deal on a great tire. Along with Nautica Competition, the newest player in men's fragrance. Gatorade Thirst Quencher. It's in college basketball. Is it in you? Conference USA corporate sponsors helping us bring you this men's basketball championship with Memphis leading South Florida 28-26. We're in the first half and it's getting late. And we have had a lot of fighting and clawing inside and the intensity. That level has been very high right from the opening tip-off.
Yeah, they've really kept the pitch at a high level. Very physical play underneath. Both backcourts going at it pretty hard out top.
Richmond at the point against the South Florida zone.
Tighten up that zone a little bit more.
Richmond from the point. Baxter, oh, did he get up for that rebound?
Good kick ahead.
And no basket. No basket off the Oglesby miss. And the foul is on Terrence Leather, his second.
Well, as you mentioned, great rebound by Baxter. And the kick out to Oglesby, unable to finish. And again, another transition basket South Florida is not able to come up with.
Seth wanted the basket, and the officials waved it off. Coming up on our Phillips 66 halftime report, your first round upsets to talk about, tournament highlights, and the Bearcats status. The Bearcats lost to Southern Mississippi last night.
You got to wonder about the tournament. I certainly think there should be no question with the way that Cincinnati has played all season long about their chances in the tournament.
But we will find out come Sunday as Cincinnati bowed out in the first round. Right here, a 30-26 lead for the Memphis Tigers. South Florida hoping to have a strong finish the last 2 minutes of the first half. Leather working on Grice. And a block from behind by Richmond, but South Florida scores anyway.
Wow, how many blocks in this game? I'll tell you, unbelievable.
A two-point game now. South Florida playing the 2-3 zone. Massie off the dribble. And there's Jimmy Baxter. Oh,
wow, get away.
Get away from me. Out of bounds, back to Memphis. The third turnover for Seth Greenberg's team.
Well, right there underneath, just trying to get deep position on the inside, and Massie, little short, Baxter says, this is my board. Get out of the way.
Here's Carney with Hunt at the point. Massie from the free throw line.
South Florida's done a good job of taking care of the basketball. Only three turnovers in the ballgame so far.
Baxter's doing a pretty good job of taking care of rebounds. She has five in the first half.
Had a season high just yesterday. Had 11 boards in the DeBall game.
Will McDonald stuffed on the baseline by Massie, and there's Carney to pick up the ball out of bounds. Good ball movement.
Yeah.
Grice for three. Will McDonald is fouled by Massie. That's two on Chris in the first half.
Yeah, he had nowhere to go to try to get that offensive rebound. Well, what has Will McDonald done? He's just been very active underneath, does a great job of running in transition, and we talked about his decisions yesterday that gave them the upset victory over DePaul, and the decisions for Will McDonald in today's game have been equally as good.
Will McDonald on the free throw line. The Tigers have 18 fouls. The Bulls have nine. 1-1 for Will. Grice rebounds. Will is 1-for-3 from the free throw line. Earl pair, and the pass was too tall for Earl. Even at 7 feet tall, he couldn't handle that one. Eight turnovers for Memphis in the first half.
Yeah, again, you know, both coaches really teach post-entry passes very well. And that time, a tough angle to get the ball inside. You've got to be sort of, right at the wing position in order to enter the ball against either one of these defenses.
About 4 seconds difference between the game clock and the shot clock. Reggie Cohen, Jeremy Hunt out front. And a foul off the ball. 16.6 seconds to go in the first half. Earl Barron, it's his second foul.
Well, they switched, Memphis switched defensive assignments on McDonald.
1-1 for Will. He missed the front end of a 1-1 just a few seconds ago. Not this time. McDonald has 10 in the first half.
Well, you get a look right here, isolation on Will McDonald and what he's doing on the inside, and the officials just sort of cleaning it up. They really don't want the grabbing and clutching and holding on the inside as this game had started out.
11 points for McDonald in the first half. We're tied at 30, and Memphis is trying to go into the locker room with the leader.
It worked.
The pressure worked. Here comes Reggie Cohn. 5 seconds to go in the first half. Oglesby from the fake and lost the ball. Rice had something to do with it, and Cohn misses the long three attempt at the horn. 30-30 our score, and we've played 20 exciting minutes of basketball. Carney scored 10 in the first half for Memphis. Will McDonald had 11. And we'll check in with the guys in Studio 66 when we come back to Louisville after you watch these messages.
When you can hear your wedding song 8 different ways, when you can see sunny skies ahead, when you can pick tulips over roses and chicken instead of beef, when you can get a reminder of why you're marrying him, when you can do all this with a calling plan starting at $19.99 a month, that's M-Life from AT&T Wireless.
Right now, get a free Motorola 120 T phone after $50 Maryland rebate. Hurry in or call 1-888-MY-M-LIFE today.
Not quite a stop sign. Yet not a matter to be taken lightly either. No problem. You've come prepared. Plenty of stopping power. And plenty of get up and go. Kelly Tires. A good deal on a great tire. Call 866-90-KELLY.
Check out these numbers right now. 30-30, the Bulls, the 10 seed. Memphis, the 2 seed. They split during the year. A 1-point game and a 7-point victory for the Memphis Tigers. Hi, everybody. Welcome back to Studio 66 alongside a guy who led Houston in assists in 1983, 84, and 85. Boy, you were pretty unselfish, weren't you?
Yeah, it was a tough team. I carried them for some years, but we got through it.
You know, you look at this ball game right
right now. A great atmosphere in the first 10 or 12 minutes.
Yeah, had a real NCAA field. You know, similar to last night, South Florida gets off to a great start only to allow their opponent to fight back. We will see if the Bulls are resilient today like they were last night.
Well, Reed, we said the theme of yesterday was upset to three teams of the lower seeds. One, number 10, Reggie Cohn set the tone by stepping outside of the launching pad.
Yeah, just a great basketball game. The second game was not so great. Brandon Spann led the Tulane Green Wave and just dominated the Houston Cougars. UAB in the smothering defense. Eric Bush was absolutely tremendous. And Sidney Bell with a good, good game. Sidney Ball. But the upset of the tournament, Southern Miss over Cincinnati. Greg Johnson with a monster. And the last 10 seconds of the game, watch Jasper Johnson come to your left, tip it in for the win. What a game that was last night.
Yeah, Reed, I was surprised that they didn't find the big guy. Nobody put a body on him. So you check the brackets now. So South Florida, they're tied at 30 with Memphis. Tulane, Louisville, what are their chances?
Yeah, you know, that's two games, strength against strength. Should be up-tempo, should be a lot of fun, and a lot of perimeter scoring.
And, of course, UAB over Charlotte, but the big upset, Southern Miss, the 12 seed over Cincinnati, the 5 seed. Cincinnati has 17 wins this year, coming off of 7 straight 25-win seasons. It's amazing the talk of this entire town. Are they in or are they out now? Did the bubble break?
Hey, listen, they are in the tournament. All we're talking about is seeding. You look at RPI, it only fell to 32, strength of schedule 7. Two good wins, Oklahoma State, and they dominated Oklahoma State and Louisville. They are in. Let me tell you something. Seeding, you only care about seeds 1 through 4, and you only care about seeds 13 through 16. Everything else, I mean, who cares? Could absolutely care less. What they do care about is they don't want to end up 13 through 16.
And plus one school that wasn't on there, Cincinnati, dominated Oregon when they were ranked number 5. Halftime here at Freedom Hall. Back to check the other conferences when we come back.
The male can often find himself in precarious situations.
It is funny. Yeah.
So how many girls have you, you know? Seriously? Me too.
Okay. Great.
Rolling Rock beer. Grab a rock.
There's nothing like the energy of the crowd.
It pushes you to play your best and motivates you when things are tough.
Fans create the atmosphere
and make the experience unbelievable.
They demand 100% effort.
They reward it with loyalty.
So thank you for being there.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Be there.
UPN Friday. It's his first day out of jail.
I told you, I'm gonna straighten up this time.
But his worst nightmare is coming true.
Your face has been on the news. They liable to shoot you on sight.
Wrongly accused and on the run.
We are now.
I'm in trap.
With everyone in the chase.
You got something I want.
The Parkers, Monique, and David Alan Greer in a comedy that's on the loose.
Come out with your hands up and you will not be harmed. Look out, he's got a gun!
Three Strikes.
Friday night at 7 on UPN 30.
Now is the time to get your team together and start practicing. NBA Hoop It Up, the world's most exciting 3-on-3 tournament, is coming your way. Whether you're young or old, a serious competitor, or playing for fun, there's a level for you. So get in on all the action.
NBA Hoop It Up returns to Beale Street on April 12th and 13th. Pick up an entry form at any local area Foot Locker. Call 901-683-2290 or log on to NBAHoopItUp.com.
America's favorite drive-in invites you to wake up to a brand new taste. Because at Sonic, we're serving a one-of-a-kind breakfast menu. Try one of our new breakfast toaster sandwiches, like our sausage, egg, and cheese with tasty sausage on thick Texas toast. Or grab our awesome breakfast burrito to go. So start your day with something different. Come to Sonic, serving breakfast all day long. Make Sonic your morning drink stop and choose from thousands of different flavor combinations, like a Sonic Sunrise, a Cherry Coke, or create your own favorite. Drive in a Sonic and have a good morning.
I want them to see me giving back my time and money to the community that I live in, to the school that I work for, that we give back to young people. And I want them to see that through action, not through speaking. I do get involved, and I try to do it with young children in mind, with the campus that I work for in mind, and with the city that I live in mind.
20 minutes in, 20 minutes to go. The Bulls of South Florida, the 10th seed, eyeing their second straight upset, tied with Memphis at 30 apiece. Hi, everybody. Welcome back to Studio 66. In the Atlantic 10, Xavier headed for their tournament, riding the crest of a 15-game winning streak. David West coming off his 7th Player of the Week honor, taking on George Washington. Let's check out. Let's go to Dayton and see what transpired. Chalmers to Keith Jackson. O'Nelly, the slam.
Yeah, you talked about David West. Three-time A-10 Player of the Year. David West is a load.
62-56 in the second half, and David West, the only guy in the Atlantic 10 averaging a double-double. Let's go to the Big Apple now. St. John's and Boston College. Troy Bell, everybody expecting the shoot, and he gives it up to Andrew Bryant.
Now, Troy Bell gives Boston College that marquee name that will keep the selection committee's attention. Troy Bell could be the secret to BC getting in on Sunday.
In the second half, of course, this is a Marcus Hatton versus Troy Bell matchup at 67-66. Marcus Hatton, St. John's, of course, riding the crest of a four-game winning streak. Let's go to Chicago now. Iowa and the Buckeyes of Ohio State. Sean Connolly, the senior, knocks down the three. Ohio State goes up early. Brody Boyd, that's his specialty as well. And bingo, hits the three. And it's 41-39 at that juncture. Ohio State right now at 61-58. The Buckeyes beat Iowa in the championship of this tournament last year.
Now let's go down to Dallas and take a look at the Phillips 66 Big 12 Conference. Tim Barnes for Iowa State hits a big three. Iowa State up big. A&M trying to fight back with Antoine Wright, but right now it's Iowa State with a huge 31-19 lead. Now it's up to 40-24, the Cyclones.
And guess what? The winner gets Kansas. Let's go to the SEC now. Ole Miss and South Carolina. South Carolina's Chris Warren. Nice drive. Hits the runner. And it's a 4-2 early lead.
Well, Ole Miss' Troy Person comes back and hits a tough jump shot in the lane.
Well, Ole Miss, they closed out the season dropping 10 of 11. The Gamecocks lost that heartbreaker to Georgia. And right now it's 23-15. Ole Miss on top in the first half. Here in Freedom Hall, we're deadlocked at 30. The Bulls and Tigers were back with more after this.
Utility when you
and
need
all
it.
The Nats magic seem to win.
The new Infiniti FX45.
Get all the sun.
It's showtime with your favorite stars and promising amateurs. Weekends on UPN 30. Saturdays at 6, Monique hosts Showtime at the Apollo with hot new artists and the Apollo stars of tomorrow. Sundays at 6, Rudy Rush and Kiki Shepherd host Showtime in Harlem with great guests, Showtime teams, Showtime kids, and Harlem's original amateur night. It's Showtime, Saturdays and Sundays at 6 on UPN 30.
How can he do this?
It's gonna be...
Who hired the DJ? He canceled?
A wedding with no music?
I got it. I'll go online and download the music.
With Roadrunner High Speed Online, you can access thousands of CDs. Click on Roadrunner Rhapsody and download music up to 50 times faster than dial.
Come on, come on, the limo's here. Come on.
Let's party.
Exceed your speed with Roadrunner High Speed Online.
Call 259-1111 and for a limited time, get Roadrunner for 3 months at half price.
1932, the world ate its first crystal.
Crystal's a cool place to be.
The crystal sack full.
They're always hot and fresh.
Steaming hot off the grill.
8 crystals, $3.99.
You can get a lot of crystals for a little bit of money.
12 crystals, $5.99.
So you can eat a lot of them and you don't feel guilty.
Smell that steam coming off that grill, you know you're in the right place.
And that square box that keeps it warm.
Sack full of crystals.
You can't beat that.
Little food, big taste.
You're kind of cute.
Thank you.
What could make a man risk his career?
Your fight.
His relationship.
I never want to see you again.
Even his life.
I'm tripping.
Oscar winner Halle Berry is all that.
What is this, the Twilight Zone?
You seem a little nervous.
I can do this.
Pleasure comes first with Strictly Business.
Saturday on UPN 30.
Platinum World Premiere, April 14th on UPN.
We're almost ready to roll into the second half. Quick check of the Mid-American Conference. Everyone remembers Kent State's run last year. Well, Kent State, winners of a Marshall today, 79-57. Boise State and SMU going at it in the WAC. Right now it's 2019, SMU by one in the first half. Chris Massie averaging a double-double. Massie with 7 points, 7 rebounds after 20 minutes, and they are deadlocked at 30. John Rooney, Ed Pinckney have the second half coming up after this.
I'm a math teacher and a basketball coach. I've always been a student of the game. There's so many split-second decisions, you have to be thinking all the time. I try to teach my girls that it starts with physical ability, but it's the thinkers that rise above. That's the reason I come to Phillips 66. I know I'll get the highest quality gasoline for my car, and I know they're always thinking of ways to improve, like my team.
Year after year, mile after mile, and for all the miles to come, Phillips 66.
So if I ran an online trading company, here's the way it would work. You'd make a trade, you'd pay the fee, a standard fee. No order handling fees or share limitations. I guess I'd run it like Ameritrade.
At Ameritrade, every online equity trade is $10.99, including stop and limit orders. No handling fees, no share limits, no gimmicks. Ameritrade, what's your share? Switch today and get $50 to help pay your transfer fee plus 30 free internet equity trades.
When athletes sweat, they lose more than just water. Gatorade puts back sodium and potassium, proven to replenish and rehydrate athletes better than water. Gatorade, is it in you?
Two world-class athletes battle for the first time ever. Kurt Angle, Brock Lesnar, the WWE Championship.
WrestleMania comes early. It's Lesnar and Angle for the WWE title.
Thursday on UPN 30.
Hollywood Casino has now beaten the Tunica Market payout average 4 years running. Hollywood Casino, your place to shine.
Kelly Tyre, South Florida and Memphis have played 20 minutes to a 30-30 tie. And in the Big Ten tournament in Chicago, Ohio State was a winner 66-64 over Iowa. Well, Ed Pinckney, I'm John Rooney. Welcome back to Freedom Hall in Louisville, Kentucky. And Carney had a big first half, scoring 10 for Memphis.
Yeah, he really did. Sort of loosened it up outside for Chris Massie underneath the basket. And it's all about ball movement. Memphis likes to work from the inside out, and they got that job done. He was equally as effective on the defensive end, a couple of big blocks, but they want to continue that trend here in the second half.
The Kelly Tyers first half highlights featuring Rodney Carney with 10 points. Reggie Cohn handles the basketball. We're underway in the second half. We hope you enjoy it. 30-30.
And the one thing you want to look at for both teams, for South Florida, the backcourt of Baxter and Cohn, they were relatively quiet with only 7 points combined by both teams. And for Memphis, they've got to get a hold of the turnovers, really turn the ball over.
Memphis basketball off the turnover, the fifth of the game for South Florida. South Florida has done a decent job protecting the ball to this point.
They really have. They've done a very good job, but South Florida really capitalizing off the turnovers of Memphis.
There is a basket on the scuff by Rodney Carney. The first points off a turnover today for Memphis.
I'll tell you, that's a good way to open up the half. You get your fans involved in the ball game right at the start. Players get a little bit jacked up.
Baxter was short. Rebounding Chris Massie. Earl Barron using up the dribble. Burks from the three-point line. Carney in the corner. 23 is Anthony Rice. With Barron and Massie inside. The backdoor play. Carney at the baseline. Fouled by Leather. Three on Terrence Leather.
You take a look back a moment ago in the alley-oop play inside to open up the half for Memphis. beautifully executed. Carney again up high, up over the top of the rim. The first foul of the second half in South Florida. Playing a zone as it did much of the game yesterday. Massie. There's a basket for Massie. Give him 9 today.
You have to be so conscious of Carney now. Massie able to shape up very well on the inside.
Massie scored 22 and 15 points in the two meetings with South Florida this season. And a timeout with 18:24 to go in the second half. This is a full timeout with the Tigers leading by 4, scoring the first 4 points of the second half.
Get in the zone. AutoZone.
If it's been 3 months or 3,000 miles since you changed your oil, then get in the zone. AutoZone. Protect your engine and change your oil today. Get in the zone.
AutoZone.
Introducing Intel Centrino Mobile Technology. The new wireless laptop technology designed to help you untangle, unburden, and unwire your life.
Horsepower all-wheel drive Infiniti FX45.
Get in the zone! AutoZone!
If you're driving around with worn-out brake pads on your car, that's dangerous. Get to AutoZone for a new set of brakes today. Get in the zone!
AutoZone!
34-30 in favor of Memphis, and Chris Massie has 7 first half points plus this in the second half.
All right, does a good job shaping up inside, gets McDonald on his back, and then horses his way in for an easy two. And I'll tell you, showing a little range right there on the left side of the basket, little short jump shot for the make for Chris Massie, but most of his damage always done on the inside of the paint.
Underneath the hoop. Cohen accepts the inbounds pass. Baxter on the wing. 19 on the shot clock.
Well, they ran this set in the first half for Baxter, and again they get another score out of it. South Florida has executed their out-of-bounds plays very well in this ball game.
Baxter with the basket and a free throw. He'll be shooting for a 6th point.
They ran that double screen for Baxter. He knows that when he gets his number called, he comes off that screen pretty hard and was able to get the curl up off the pass by Reggie Cohn.
Baxter has 6 as we check out other scores from the conference tournaments around the country on the Ameritrade scoreboard. Iowa State's leading Texas A&M. Nebraska and Missouri play later in the Big 12.
But this is absolutely the best time of the year.
You can keep your eye on all the college basketball with us as we follow the USA tournament.
Just sit me in a room with a couple of TVs. I'm great.
So is that all you need, too?
You
can get your 4 or 5 if you
got to get the split TV going, man. A little bit of TiVo action working.
We'll just stack them up there in your room for you, and you can check them all out. We'll get the satellite.
Just
feed.
Lock me up, man. I'll be done April 7th.
Well, this is a good one today. 34-33 Memphis. McDonald on the block with Barron. Cohn for 3. And he's short. Cohn in the first half scored only 4 points after having an 18-point first half yesterday.
Yeah, the backcourt for South Florida trying to get a little bit more active here in the second half.
Barron was fighting Massie for the loose ball. Earl knocked the ball out of bounds to South Florida. And Barron will get a breather. Number 11, DeJuan Irwin, a sophomore from Huntsville, Alabama. He had 2 points, 2 rebounds against South Florida in the loss at home. Did not score in 19 minutes at South Florida. McDonald from the baseline. This is Baxter getting way up there. I'll tell you, you know, there was a question of whether or not they were going to have him for next season, and he actually committed to Greenberg just a couple of months ago. Again, talked about his trying to make the 2004 Olympic team.
A steal for Reggie Cohn. Nice anticipation. The race is on with Rice. Cohn wins it. Now, Memphis wants a timeout. 30-second timeout.
They have just turned the ball over each and every time, and South Florida has capitalized off those turnovers. You see Cohn with great anticipation on the pass out back to the wing and just sizes up his man and finishes nicely up on the play.
And Baxter. You might think, as Baxter finishes this play, that you might not have to really go to the pass when you're that far away from the basket. But with Cohn and some of the others that we've seen in this game, if you don't approach the pass as your teammate is delivering that pass to you, that's what happens.
Yeah, John, you're absolutely right. You've got to come, especially in the second half. A step to the ball is a must against a very active zone defense. And, you know, for Memphis, they at times haven't had that.
Sometimes that zone can lull you to sleep if you're not attacking.
Yeah, Reggie Cohn did a nice job of reading the lane very well. You see the points off turnovers in favor of South Florida.
South Florida forcing the 10 turnovers, and Richmond on the wing now. Inside Massie. He's fouled. Baker was contesting along with Leather. And it is Baker with the foul, his third. Joseph Baker and Terrence Leather, each with three fouls.
Well, the one thing that Memphis does, and they get that South Florida zone moving from left to right, and then finally find Massie deep inside the paint. Wow.
Ooh.
I'll tell you, as soon as he let that go, he knew that was not going to make it.
An air ball on the free throw for Massie, a 68% shooter, and this was too strong. Baker fighting for the rebound with Carney. Baker wins. Reggie Cohn with Burks all over him. This is a good matchup out front. Cohn traveled. Cohn thought about going for the shot, then made the pass, and with the indecision, committed the turnover. We'll be right back to Louisville.
It's thumbs up for America's favorite film critics.
There was no reason for this film. We've seen it all before.
One of the few Hollywood programs that dares to challenge Hollywood.
And the two leads are adorable.
But the movie is tiresome.
Well-reasoned. Thought-provoking.
If you're buying it as a comedy, I guess you could buy it.
I agree, it is a comedy.
Smart. Confident.
I found a real juice and a real passion in this material.
I thought this thing was a howler.
They put the movies in focus. Ebert and Roper.
Sunday on UPN 30.
Left to its own devices, money can get out of control. That's why First Tennessee offers a strict regimen of discipline and guidance, like our priority choices checking. It offers lots of options, free perks, and rewards, so your account can be designed specifically for you. All to keep your money doing the right things. And never out of control. First Tennessee, all things financial.
You're a great mom. You're beautiful and you're smart and you work so hard.
Billy, would you like me to call your mom and see if he can stay for dinner?
If you insist.
Introducing the Cinemeal Deal. Any large Pizza Hut pizza, America's favorite, with up to three toppings, just $11.99. Plus a generous order of our new freshly baked cinnamon sticks absolutely free. The $11.99 Cinemeal Deal. Spoil your family, not your budget.
You're powerful, smart.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
At Pizza Hut.
Iowa tied at 64. Brent Darby with the go-ahead. 66-64. Chauncey Leslie, the senior, dribbling through traffic, hits the front of the rim. And Iowa in the finals the last 2 years. Not this time. The Buckeyes, the defending champs, stay alive, knocking off Iowa. Let's go back down to John. All right, thank you very much, Mike. Boston College and St. John's. And our game, 40% shooting for USF. Memphis at 36%. And check out the points off turnovers as we've had four ties and six lead changes.
Absolutely a huge difference right there. Memphis has got to get control of handling the ball.
Memphis scored the first 4 points of the second half. The Bulls had come back with the last seven. The last Memphis field goal was with 18:36 to go. We've gone almost 3 minutes without a score.
Really, you know, for Memphis, it's been tough sort of trying to read this defense. I know Seth Greenberg prefers to play man-to-man, but the zone in Conference USA tournament has fared very well.
Worked yesterday. Carney, that spins off the volley. Rice inside, Richmond outside.
Wow.
The volley, who's going to win this one? Richmond does. The transfer in from the Vanderbilt program for Memphis.
They just get up on the glass. A couple of different opportunities. Let's see what they do.
Massie loses the handle on the basketball. Richmond's there, though.
Opportunity
number
four.
Lucky he has fly paper there in his hands. Or a magnet. The ball comes right to him. A reach. Massie trying to catch the ball, and Leather got him. Four on Terrence Leather.
Boy, you see Leather, he is livid. But again, the officials talking to us right before this game started in the second half, and they said they were going to clean up all of the little chippy pushing and shoving underneath the basket.
Leather at 6'9 goes out, and 5'10 Brian Swift comes in for South Florida.
Another turnover.
Another turnover, and here comes Swift with the lob. Inside for the dunk by Baker. That was great ball movement by the Bulls.
I'll tell you, Memphis has really played some good basketball, but the difference here is that, you know, South Florida really believes that they can beat this ball club.
Baxter for three. Short. He didn't follow his shot. Antonio Burks cleans it up for Memphis. Richmond saves the ball in the corner. Long pass for Bryce. And John Calipari takes a 30-second timeout.
One of the things that Will McDonald said after the ball game, and Seth Greenberg really had to get a hold of him before he finished off his comment, was that we know we are better than Memphis. And Greenberg said what he really means is that we're going to go out and play a hard-fought game tomorrow against a highly-ranked ball club. But, you know, I think that feeling goes throughout this South Florida ball club.
And if you don't feel that way, why are you on the floor to begin with?
Absolutely. And we'll look at this playoff, the fast break. Baxter can't get a hold of the finish on the alley-oop, so
he hit his trailing man.
That's right.
Except Baker, and Baker has scored 6 points. 26 on the shot clock for the Tigers to operate. Coming out of their short timeout. Earl Barron checked in at the timeout. Carney at the three-point line and Burks out front. Massie is trying to get some room inside. Here's Carney. Baxter got a hand on it, and then it dawned on Brian Swift that, you know, that was touched by my guy. I better try to save it.
He caught it right at the last second.
I thought he was going to end up in your lap, yeah. 14:08 to go in the second half, and a 5-point Bulls lead. The 35-second clock for Memphis.
You see the backside of the zone is where Memphis has gotten a couple of scores.
Here's Barron in the lane, and he scores finally. The last field goal was at 18:36 of this half for Memphis. Here we are at 13:47 and counting. Baxter. Cone. He misses another one. Massie with the rebound. Cone is 0 for 4 from behind the arc today. Here's Massie. Foul.
I'll tell you, he just grinds you down underneath. You simply can't take a breather against him on the defensive end, because that last time able to get the rebound, start the fast break, and then finish off by drawing the foul.
Massie shot an air ball and then was strong on a second free throw earlier this half. So he's perfect on this one. Short, long, then right down the middle. Massie is 2 for 5 from the line. He has 10 points, 9 rebounds.
He's having a little trouble at that free throw line.
The just one rebound away from another double-double for Chris Massie. Two-point lead now for South Florida. Traveling.
We talked about trying to execute against the zone of South Florida. You'll see right on the back side of the zone, South Florida really concentrating. That'll give Memphis the opportunity to get in the middle right here and get a quick score. Well executed.
Massie a miss. Cone comes away for South Florida. Cone a long three. Oh, that's way off.
That was a heat check right there.
Earl Barron. The official stopping play. And what's this all about?
They're just cleaning it up.
Mm-hmm. They're trying to keep control of this game as this could really get out of hand the last 13:02.
Absolutely.
If they don't take care of this.
Yeah. You talked about this, right? Coming back into the second half. We're just not going to stand for it.
Yeah, you had a visit with Hal Lusk, and Tom O'Neill is delivering the lecture now to the Memphis players. Earl Barron goes out.
And that's what he talked about. You see Cone. Cone says he loves these rims. Man, way behind that three-point line, but just can't get tangled up or jockey against one another.
Massey's looking for help after using up the dribble. The Tigers can tie it or take the lead with three on this trip. Ron Erland setting the pick. Carney around the corner to Burks. Or to, excuse me, Rice. And now back out front it goes to Jeremy Hunt. Here's Carney with five on the shot clock. Hunt. Rice gets the rebound.
Boy, Memphis beginning to dominate off the offensive glass. They have had just a ton of offensive rebounds here.
Massie inside against McDonald, and a foul called against McDonald. That's three on Will.
I'll tell you, unless you get any pressure on the passer, dumping the ball inside to Massie, I mean, they're going to ride him all the way through this second half. He continues to draw fouls on the inside.
Massie is shooting two. He's 2-for-6 from the free throw line.
The foul's always a question with McDonald. Only got to play limited minutes in the first half of yesterday's game against DePaul.
He finished with 14 points, going 6-for-7 from the field, but he was available down the stretch when they had to have him. And it's Cone stepping in front of Massie for the rebound. 11 points for Chris Massie. He averages 17-3 a game. 1-point lead for the Bulls.
Oh, wide open.
And they missed a layup, but a dunk by McDonald.
Says, I got your back, big fella.
Here's Massie out to Hunt. Carney opened at the three-point line. Count it.
Quick release, too.
Tied at 41. The fifth time we've been tied today, and we've had six lead changes.
Here we go.
11 and a half left. And a reach by DeJuan Irwin fouling McDonald. That's one on Irwin today. We are tied at 41. With 11:28 left in the second half. South Florida, the number 10 seed. And Will McDonald has 13 of South Florida's 41 points. The action is going to get hotter yet, I think.
Not quite a stop sign. Yet not a matter to be taken lightly either. No problem. You've come prepared. Plenty of stopping power. And plenty of get up and go. Kelly Tires. A good deal on a great tire. Call 866-90-KELLY.
We'll be right back.
committed. He stuck with it. He never lost sight of his goal. The hard work and determination paid off.
Phillips 66 is proud to be title sponsor of Conference USA Basketball. We know performance starts with commitment.
Well, score tied here right here with 11:28 left. And what we're going to take a look at right here is good ball movement on Memphis's part. Right here, you'll see the overload of the zone. And Chris Massie kicks that right out. And you're going to have a weak side shot right there. And boom, that's what you've got to do in order to execute well against the South Florida zone. It has been tough against Memphis so far, but doing a better job of getting the ball, good ball movement through Massie here in the second half.
The three you just saw, a three ball by Carney gives him 15 points, and one of four field goals made this second half by Memphis, going 4 for 15.
Well, he's going to be left wide open because, again, South Florida doesn't want to give Massie an opportunity to get those easy scores or create the fouls to McDonald on the inside.
McDonald at the high post now, guarded by DeWander. Carney's guarding Baxter. Baxter's looking to get in the middle, elevate. He did, and he was fouled. Carney couldn't stay with him well enough to block the shot. Carney's first foul. 13th foul on the Tigers. This is a shooting foul. It's Jimmy Baxter, junior from St. Petersburg, Florida. 40 minutes against DePaul. That was the third game this season he has played the entire game.
Well, superb athlete, 11th in the world in the high jump. This guy can really get up and has improved upon his game throughout the year.
Baxter is a 64% free throw shooter. Right now, these free throws are enormous. 41-41 our score. From the line, 6 of 11 today for South Florida, 8 for 15 for the Memphis Tigers.
That's the thing. You simply, you know, when it comes to this time during the ball game, you got to have everything. Limited turnovers, the free throw shooting's got to be on point.
Garrick Morris goes to the bench. Oglesby and Reggie Cohen are out front in the 2-3 zone. Well, here's Massie. Oh, it spins out on him. Baker rebounds for South Florida.
That time it was single coverage as well. Seth Greenberg taking a little bit of a gamble by using McDonald to defend against Massie.
Jones calling for the ball to reset the offense with 15 on the shot clock. Oh, Cohen didn't have the shot. Burks was able to get past Baker's pick. This is a three-point attempt, and it won't go for Baxter. Juan Irwin for the Tigers. Here comes Antonio Burks. South Florida's 1 of 9 from three-point range.
Yeah, the tempo has simply slowed down.
21 on the shot clock for Memphis to inbound.
Yeah, both teams just trying to make sure they get the absolute best possible shot down court.
Irwin out, Barron back in. Earl Barron has scored 3 points. He has 2 fouls. Massie in on McDonald and throws it up there anyway. McDonald's called for the foul, his fourth.
It was really a gamble, I'll tell you, because Massie is just very difficult to get around. McDonald does it. He gets him on his back, and right there is the bump. And the way the officials have actually been calling the game, it was really a bit of a gamble.
And McDonald kept moving into it.
Yeah.
Had he just put the hands up and stayed there, remained stationary, I think he would have been all right on that play.
That's a good move by Calipari in terms of getting the ball inside and knowing that McDonald had those 3 fouls.
For Massie. The Tigers lead 43-42. Freedom Hall, Louisville, Kentucky, the quarterfinals of Conference USA action. I'm John Rooney along with Ed Pinkney. Jimmy Baxter in on Carney. And blocked by Carney. Cohn up to Oglesby.
I'll tell you, South Florida McDonald goes to the bench, and Seth Greenberg knows it. That foul gave Memphis new life.
A good timeout for Seth Greenberg because things were coming unraveled out around the three-point line for South Florida. Let's take a look.
Well, no longer the opportunity to work inside out. Baxter tries to go in, and then Cohn a little bit unsure of the shot. Oglesby not sure. And Seth Greenberg, you're right, he called that timeout right at the perfect time.
Coming up, Tulane against Louisville, 3:30 Eastern, 2:30 Central. Tonight, UAB against the number one seed and the eighth-ranked team in the country, Marquette, followed by Southern Miss and St. Louis, 9:30 Eastern, 8:30 Central. That's from ESPN+. Where do you think Marquette will be seated, Ed?
We will know during this weekend, but boy, the way that they have played throughout the entire season, strength of schedule, they got to be one of the top seeds coming out.
Here's Baxter. Cohn forcing this one up as time ran down on the clock, and a foul called as Oglesby was going for the basketball.
Well, South Florida is going to have to get a little bit extra from all three perimeter players right now with McDonald on the bench.
Third foul on Jeremy Hunt.
It's a tough rebound by Oglesby.
Baseline jumper, no good. Hunt with the rebound. Burks, Earl Barron's open inside the arc. Five for Earl Barron.
I'll tell you, Burks does an absolute fantastic job of pushing the ball, drawing the defense, and then kicking it out.
Ed, since Will McDonald's fourth foul, the momentum has gone right over to the Memphis Tigers.
No question. South Florida back on their heels right now.
And on the attempt to go to the lane, Brandon Brigman is fouled. Second foul on Carney.
I mean, this was all Burke right here. He created the shot. I mean, you find with your feet set, that was a good look.
Antonio Burks with 7 assists today. Cohn missed another one. Brigman, and he gets fouled.
Boy, Cohn having a tough time getting it going here.
Three fouls on Earl Barron. Team fouls are even, 6 apiece. Bergman, a sophomore from Philadelphia, 4 minutes against DePaul yesterday, did not score, had 2 rebounds.
Well, really, Seth Greenberg does not expect him to score out on the floor. He's sort of like your team enforcer. Very physical player is Brigman.
Oh, missed that one altogether. You see that every now and then. We've got 2 of those in the game.
Yeah. Close the windows in here. Little breezy on the free throw line.
South Florida is 7 for 14 from the free throw line. Massie and a double team. Brigman pushed him and a foul. Brigman's first foul. There's your enforcer. He didn't get the enforcement accomplished.
Well, I'll tell you, Massie, you need dynamite to blast him out of the post. It's just been a parade to the foul line here for him in the second half.
Massie, 5 for 10, 5 for 11 from the free throw line. 13 points, along with 9 rebounds. Brigman and Oglesby out, Swift and Morris in for Seth Greenberg and the South Florida Bulls.
Greenberg's got to make a decision if Memphis is able to pull away any more. You got 8:32 here, McDonald with the 4 fouls.
Massie, he's been on the free throw line most of this second half. He's 6 for 12 from the line. That's 14 points. Only 1 for 3 from the field this half. South court is trying to cut into a four-point Memphis lead with Cohn in the lane. Fouled. Cohn's having trouble from the outside, so a little bit of that won't hurt South Florida at all, Ed.
That's a good decision by him, understanding that the jump shot's not falling, so he goes to the floor, gets inside against Burks. Just couldn't get the end one, but the foul is good enough for two at the line. And boy, both teams really having a tough day from the line.
This one's in play for Reggie Cohn, 8:15 to go in the second half. And Cohn, who is the son of a coach, he's going to make a fine coach himself later on when his basketball playing days are over.
I agree. He has a great understanding of the game.
46-43, Memphis. Here's Barron. Too strong off the glass. Carney up big and strong. But Swift keeps the ball loose in South Florida. Great hustle by Baxter, and here's Cohn in the front court.
Who wants it? Who wants it?
Brian Swift plays the point now. A three-point game in favor of Memphis. Reggie Cohn has not hit a three-point basket today. He draws contact and goes back to the free throw line.
I'll tell you. Man, he is tough as nails, boy, I'll tell you. Just goes inside and draws another one.
Reggie Cohn, a senior from Winter Park, Florida. 37 minutes against DePaul yesterday with 23 points. Today, Cohn has scored 8. 7:24 left, second half. Conference USA quarterfinal action, Memphis by 2. Cohn tries to make it a one-point game. Cohn has scored 9. And boy, the emotion we've seen right from the opening tip-off today. Some tough calls inside, some good three-point baskets, and the coaches and players, they're putting everything into this one.
The thing about being the basketball coach here at the University of Memphis, it just carries a different kind of weight. You can walk into boardrooms, you can walk into gymnasiums, and have the ability to bring people together in this job. So I understand my job is to coach, to mold young men, to win basketball games, to get those young men educated. And if I do that, I'll have the ability to move this community together and do things as the basketball coach.
It's Toyota's nationwide spring sales event, where value begins with an all-star lineup of quality Toyota trucks. Now get 0% financing on the full-size V8-powered Tundra. That's 0% on the truck with the best resale value in its class. Or choose up to $1,500 cash back. Plus, there are big savings on Tacoma. Ask your dealer about the biggest factory-to-dealer incentives of the year during Toyota's nationwide spring sales event at Covington Pike, Chuck Hutton, or Performance Toyota now.
Now is the time to get your team together and start practicing. NBA Hoop It Up, the world's most exciting three-on-three tournament, is coming your way. Whether you're young or old, a serious competitor, or playing for fun, there's a level for you. So get in on all the action.
NBA Hoop It Up returns to Beale Street on April 12th and 13th. Pick up an entry form at any local area Foot Locker. Call 901-683-2290 or log on to NBAHoopItUp.com.
Conference USA Tournament action presented by Kelly Tires, with Memphis leading 46-45, 7:24 to go in the second half. Memphis has been able to hit the three ball today.
Well, Rodney Carney has really been the guy who has spearheaded the three-point barrage from the outside, and Memphis has got to continue that outside shooting in order to keep Massie effective.
One three-pointer by South Florida today. That was by Danny Oglesby. And Shooting the Rock is brought to you by Rolling Rock Beer. Grab a rock. Memphis has 5 three-pointers to the Tigers' credit.
You take a look at those numbers, only 1-for-11 from the field, but what has held South Florida in this ball game is the ability to convert on the turnovers of Memphis. They've really done a good job there.
South Florida scored 11 three-pointers yesterday. 7 by Reggie Cohn. Only 1 three-ball today, that by Danny Oglesby in the first half. 1 point in favor of Memphis. South Florida with a zone that's been very effective the first couple of rounds of the Conference USA tournament. Here's Burks. Missing short. Earl Barron's right there. A line drive shot won't go. Richmond has been able to run the ball down several times today for Memphis.
Yeah, good second chance opportunities for Memphis here in the second half.
Richmond for three.
Boy, you got to get a handle on the offensive rebounding, and it becomes all the more important with McDonald out of the ball game. You just got to take it back out underneath the basket, and it gives an opportunity for Memphis to get set on the defensive end.
Here's Baxter. He can't answer the three by Richmond on the other end, and in the volley, Baker. He'll be on the line, shooting two. Talking about the offensive rebounds, Ed, Memphis has 17 today.
Yeah. I mean, they've absolutely crashed the boards on the inside, but Baker trying to make good on the other end for South Florida. Carved some space out right there in order to draw the foul.
The foul on Earl Barron, and that's the fourth on Earl. Yusuf Baker, one more coming. South Florida for the free throw line. 10 out of 19. Memphis isn't much better. 11 out of 19.
Oh, it just gives you an opportunity. Makes good on that one.
Maybe Baker would have been better off fading away like he did on that, making that free throw when he shot the first one. South Florida needs a big stop, and Memphis wants to keep the momentum rolling the Tigers' way. Grice short.
Boy, look at the pursuit.
Out of bounds off Baxter.
The rebound. The pursuit by Memphis after the rebound is just unbelievable. I mean, they are going after it. Here's the long ball. And just, they are all over it.
Richmond low for the Massie dunk. Massie's second field goal of the second half, and he has 16 points. The Tigers have their biggest lead of the day, 51-46. Baxter shoots a three attempt, way short, an air ball. Out of bounds, the ball belongs to the Tigers.
When does McDonald come in? And we'll take a look at the last basket by Memphis. A kick out, then just right through the zone. Memphis carves through for the Massie slam.
South Florida didn't know what to do. Is Richmond going to pull up, take the three? Now is he going to take the jump shot and then left Massie open for the dunk? Memphis has 15 second chance points. And here's the shot by Burks. This time, South Florida. Make sure Memphis stays off the glass. Jimmy Baxter there for the ball.
Went up high to get that one. Boy, that was close to an offensive foul.
Very close. Swift. He misses the three attempt. There's Massie clearing out the ground around the lane. South Florida against Memphis. Conference USA tournament action with Ed Pinckney. I'm John Rooney. Massie has 16, McDonald 13, but McDonald's been on the bench with four fouls.
You know, that's that last shot by Memphis. It's kind of one of the shots where the coaching staff goes, no! Oh! Man, that was a quick shot by Memphis.
Quick shot by Cone didn't go. Garrett Morris with the rebound, and he is fouled. Chris Massie committed his third foul, and junior Garrick Morris from West Palm Beach, Florida, to the free throw line shooting two. Morris has been known as a shot blocker, 155 for his career at South Florida. A 63% free throw shooter, and is there a lid on the basket on three throws today?
One was halfway down.
South Florida is 11 for 21 on free throw attempts. Well, McDonald will come back in after the free throw by Morris.
And as soon as he comes in, again, we'll look to see if South Florida sort of runs their offense through him. They did just yesterday, and that's what McDonald feels about the miss. Man, we need those. We need those little easy ones.
McDonald reacting to the miss by Garrick Morris, and then Morris nailed the second free throw. Jeremy Hunt to Massie, in on McDonald. McDonald can't do much. Yeah. Massie banks it in.
Yeah, he can go right at him. You see, McDonald, all he can do is sort of just keep his hands up.
18 for Massie. To go along with 11 rebounds as he posts a double-double here in the Conference USA Tournament. Under 4 minutes left, Reggie Cohn. Baxter slashing and scoring.
Boy, he is some athlete. I thought he was going to come up on the other side. Beautiful finish on the right side by Baxter.
Hunt from the three-point line. Traveling. Jimmy Baxter at 3 points in the first half. 8 now in the second half. On his cutting move to the basket, South Florida trails 53-49.
The male can often find himself in precarious situations.
It is funny.
So how many girls have you, you know? Seriously? Me too.
Okay. Great.
Rolling Rock beer. Grab a rock.
When you can hear your wedding song 8 different ways. When you can see sunny skies ahead. When you can pick tulips over roses and chicken instead of beef. When you can get a reminder of why you're marrying him. When you can do all this with a calling plan starting at $19.99 a month. That's M Life from AT&T Wireless.
Right now, get a free Motorola 120T phone after $50 mail-in rebate. Hurry in or call 1-888-MY-M-LIFE today.
My name is Bill, and I'm a money coach. You could say I'm in it for the money. Every dollar has potential. Money doesn't want to work hard. I train it to work hard.
First Tennessee's priority choices can sweep extra money from checking into money market investments, where it works harder for you. Enter First Tennessee's Working Money Sweepstakes. You could win $150,000. Stop by for details. Put your money to work. Call or visit First Tennessee.
Today's Conference USA game has been brought to you by Phillips 66, where we put the best in our super clean gasolines so you get the most out of your car. Think smart, think performance, think Phillips 66. Kelly Tires, a good deal on a great tire. NikeBasketball.com. And by Intel Centrino Mobile Technology, laptop technology designed to unwire your life.
Mike Gleason in Studio 66. Coming up right after the game, we'll check the other conference tournaments around the country. We'll preview that Louisville-Tulane game. And, John, we just learned that Marvin Stone will not play for Louisville in Game 2. Let's go back to you. Mike, we were handed the release. University of Louisville senior center Marvin Stone has not been cleared to play in the Cardinals' quarterfinal game against Tulane in the Conference USA tournament. U of L officials continue to work with the NCAA on the matter. Stone sat out 2 earlier games while his amateur status was being addressed. He missed a Cardinals victory over Charlotte and the March 8th regular season finale and sat out the East Carolina game. So Stone will not play today.
Boy, unfortunate. I mean, without Ellis Miles and Stone, a huge part of what Louisville does in terms of their front line on offense and defense. Quick hitter.
That time, Richmond fell asleep. Baxter, give him 13 today. Now it's a 2-point game. 3 minutes to go, Ed.
Out-of-bounds sets have been so big for South Florida.
Baxter, near steal, and Barron got it back. Here's Richmond in on Baxter. A foul.
You go back to that set, and watch as Memphis, they just have their back to the out-of-bounds play, not ready to go offensively, and boom. They get a quick hitter. Baxter able to put that one up and in.
Then on the other end of the floor, Baxter committed his third foul. Richmond has another free throw coming. This has not been a free throw clinic today. 11 out of 20 are the Tigers from the free throw line. Richmond has 6 points, going 1 for 2 on the line here. A 3-point lead for the Tigers. Keep in mind, Reggie Combe, who nailed 7 3-point field goals yesterday, hasn't hit one today. Has 9 total points after scoring 23, 18 of those in the first half against DePaul. And Seth Greenberg wants a timeout. With Memphis leading South Florida, 54-51. South Greenberg wants to call a timeout to gather his troops as his team is down by 3. In 1999, March the 3rd, overtime action between Memphis and South Florida. Altron Jackson led South Florida with 22 points. South Florida scored 6 straight points at overtime to clinch the victory for Coach Seth Greenberg, 88-81.
Well, it's just been a long time coming for Memphis. It's sort of been one and done for the past couple of years for them, but Calipari's brought new life to this ball club and the program.
South Florida has gone 5-7 all time in the Conference USA tournament, and yesterday's first round win gave them 3 consecutive first round wins in the tournament. Leather for Baxter.
What Baxter was going to go up with that, he sort of fumbled the ball.
Leather open, but short-armed the shot. McDonald scores after getting the offensive rebound.
That's a big hit. He just makes such a difference underneath the basket.
What he did late in the game yesterday against DePaul. 1-point game. Calipari wants to talk about it. 1 timeout left each way. A 1-point lead for Memphis. Memphis with the ball and 2 minutes even on the game clock.
Both coaches understanding that each possession with 2 minutes left to go is so very important. Just trying to make sure that each team gets a good look at the basket.
As you mentioned earlier, Memphis is on an 11-game winning streak. After the start of the conference season, Memphis lost 3 out of 4 from January the 11th through the 25th, and no L's since then. They lost at Southern Miss, against South Florida at the Pyramid, and then at St. Louis. We talked about McDonald and Massie so much at the beginning of our game. Here is how they stack up through the day, each making 6 field goals, even though McDonald has 4 more shots. 9 rebounds for McDonald, and Massie has the double-double.
I'll tell you, both would have even more points if they could have gotten any rhythm from the free throw line.
South Florida stays with the zone. Here's Hunt.
Oh, wow.
With 1:45 to go in the game, Hunt hits his first field goal of the day.
What a big hit. That was a big one.
Hunt turned an ankle in practice yesterday, was a little sore during the shoot-around, but no ill effects from a bad ankle on that 3-ball. Reggie Cohn high off the glass.
Boy, Cohn with the teardrop right down the lane.
The Tigers have the ball at a 2-point lead.
Side.
Hunt stepping up. Burks. The volley won by Terrence Leather. Under 1 minute to go, and the Bulls with a chance to tie or take the lead with 3. Seth Greenberg uses up a timeout. That's his last timeout.
Boy, Boy, the ball movement, and then just Hunt steps right into that one. Big hit. But then back on the other end, how about Reggie Cone? The three-point shot not working for him, so he goes right down the lane amongst the trees and gets it high up off the glass.
And Benge, the three shot hasn't worked at all for South Florida today. And Reggie Cone is 0 for 8 from behind the arc, and the team is 1 for 14. Oglesby hit that in the first half.
This is a pretty smart ball club, South Florida. They have learned how to win in other ways. As you mentioned, the three ball not working. They've taken advantage of points off turnovers, used the zone defense very well.
While Cone is 0 for 8 from behind the arc, he's 4 for 4 inside. Now, with 18 fouls, the Bulls have a foul to give here for a 1-1. Memphis with a lead here, 57-55. In four conference championships, Memphis has put together a 70% winning record in conference play. And Don Calipari took his team to the Final Four of the NIT and then the championship, beating South Carolina last year. And he'll be going to the NCAAs this year.
I'll tell you right here, I believe South Florida is going to go inside to McDonald. He's been money for South Florida down the stretch.
And a reach. Earl Barron and Massie trying to deny the ball inside the McDonald. Earl Barron has just fouled out with 41.8 seconds to go.
Right here, he shapes up very well. Little dump down pass inside by Cone. Barron just trying to come up over the back. And McDonald, again, he has made just fantastic decisions for South Florida in crunch time of ball games.
Seth Greenberg's huddle for South Florida. Earl Barron, who just fouled out of the game with 41.8 to go, finished the day with 5 points and 7 rebounds. And you look, number 45, Will McDonald. He has been plagued by foul trouble today. 15 points. And while he was out of the lineup, Memphis put on a run to take the lead, yet the Bulls have been able to fight back. There was at one point in the game I thought if Memphis could keep that intensity, they'd just go ahead and run away with the game, the way they were hitting the offensive boards and the way they were getting so many second-chance opportunities.
Well, give a lot of credit to both Cone and Baxter, who sort of held the fort down until McDonald could get back in the game and really take care of the basket underneath.
Will McDonald was 3 for 5 from the free throw line, and you saw the free throw shooting for both teams. It hasn't been good today. One more for McDonald with 41.8 to go.
Boy.
He missed them both.
They have just been stymied at the line today.
John Grice to the front court. Antonio Burks. And Cohen fouls Burks. That's the ninth team foul, 1-1 coming up for Burks.
Boy, and you can just see the disappointment on McDonald's face after missing those two free throws.
There's McDonald, 15 points today. McDonald from the free throw line has got 3 for 7. There's 9 rebounds to go along with the 15 points. Antonio Burks. As a free throw shooter, 71% this season. 1 for 1 today. He has 4 rebounds and 8 assists.
Done a good job running the show today for John Calipari.
He just earned a bonus.
Cool as ice.
4 points for Burks. 58-55 Memphis. Half minute to go in Louisville, Kentucky in the quarterfinals of the Conference USA tournament. A 5-point day for Burks, who averages 9.5 a game.
No timeouts for South Florida. They'll have to get a quick hitter here.
Swift stepped out of bounds.
They're just trying to set up a shot for Reggie Cone. He was on the right side, deep in the corner. Swift couldn't get it back out to him. Got caught underneath the basket.
Grice and Hunt hurry into the lineup while Richmond and Irwin go out for Memphis. Baxter will contest the inbounds pass for South Florida.
This will be a quick swipe and then an immediate foul.
Carney, Leather fouls him. Now let's check out our Phillips 66 player of the game. A double-double for Chris Massie today. 18 points and 11 rebounds. And Ed, as you pointed out, that point total could be much higher with a few free throws made.
No question about it. 15th double-double for Chris Massie on the season. And I'll tell you, through double teams, through zone defense, he still was able to get the job done.
Leather, who committed the foul, sending Carney to the free throw line, fouled out. He leaves the game with 5 points and five rebounds. Danny Oglesby talking to Seth Greenberg. Oglesby replaces Leather in the lineup with 22.3 seconds to go. Rodney Carney scored 10 points in the first half, going 2-for-2 from the free throw line. This is his first trip to the line in the second half. But Memphis trying to put it way out of reach here. And he missed it. Rodney Carney, a member of the Conference USA All-Freshman team.
What? This free throw line.
It hasn't been good at all today.
No, not at all.
South Florida 12-for-24, Memphis 14-for-24. Now with 20 seconds to go, the 5-point lead. Oglesby missed the three. Baxter can't get it back. Yes, he does. McDonald with the catch, and he's fouled. Four on Massie.
That's the last thing you want to do is stop that clock for Memphis. I'll tell you, second chance opportunities for South Florida. McDonald able to draw the foul.
McDonald has scored 15 today. He's 3 out of 8 from the free throw line. He's missed his last three. Perfect on this one. 16 for Will McDonald. 9 rebounds. 10.6 seconds to go. Tigers by 4. And Reggie Cohn holds Carney as the ball comes inbounds.
Well, I'll tell you, Memphis coming into this tournament, they have played some fantastic basketball.
Memphis is trying to win its 12th straight game and improve to 23-5 as the Tigers have enjoyed 3 straight 20-win seasons.
You know, they also feel as though they've sort of been slighted a little bit in terms of...
Seventeen for Rodney Carney. 4 out of 5 from the line for him. He has shot the ball well from the free throw line. An 18-point game. He averages 9-7 a game. Time running down on South Florida's season. Garrick Morris lost the handle to John Grice. Here's Burks to Massie. No basket. But the Tigers have won their 12th straight game. To 56, Memphis with the victory over South Florida. Memphis awaits the winner of the Louisville-Tulane game that is coming up shortly. And Stone will not be playing today for Louisville. Well, this was an exciting game, a 30-30 score at the half, only to have Memphis. After Will McDonald got his fourth foul, the momentum shifted the Tigers' way, and they made the most of it. And here are the brackets as Memphis moves on to play the winner of Louisville-Tulane and in some good matchups tonight. The top seed, conference champion, regular season champ Marquette will play UAB, and UAB was just tough in advancing yesterday. And St. Louis will play Southern Mississippi. Southern Mississippi upended Cincinnati in our late game last night. But Memphis moves on in the tournament, moving on to the semifinals thanks to a 62-56 win over South Florida. South Florida has a record of 15-14 now after going 7-9 in Conference USA.
And I'll tell you, really a great win for Memphis. We'll start out on the right foot, right at the start.
Rodney Carney today scored 18 points. He had 10 in the first half, and he made the Conference USA All-Freshman team. Ray Geddes is courtside.
Well, freshman sensation Rodney Carney. Rodney, a terrific basketball game. I thought you did a great job, especially down the line, at the end of the game at the free throw line.
I just really tried to stay comfortable, you know. I didn't want to get rattled, you know. So I was really relaxed and took good shots with the free throws. And Chris, he asked me to hit them for him, so I had to hit them for him.
Now, our Ed Pinkney said one of the keys to the game was going to be an inside-outside attack. Chris Massie had a good game. You had a good game. Is that something y'all have done all season?
Really is, because they'll double shoot team him, and he'll just kick it out for the open shot, and I just concentrated on getting to him and spacing out for him. That's really all.
Now, Rodney, you guys were in a dogfight. Did you expect that this afternoon?
I expected it because they did some talking, and they said there wasn't going to be a game like last time. And so we came out, you know, and we felt the momentum, and we realized this wasn't going to be no easy game, so we just had to clamp down and really lock them.
Yeah, they may have said it wasn't going to be a game, but it was a game. You had a terrific afternoon. Good luck to you. Go get some rest, okay? Yeah, John Calipari stepping in. Hey, Coach, how are you? Congratulations on a great win. I thought the key to this game was in the second half. I thought you guys dominated the offensive boards.
Well, it hurt us in the first half, as many offensive rebounds as they got, but we're a little tentative. You know, this team, we're still learning about ourselves. I thought Seth had a great game plan of packing it in, playing zone the whole game, and it's hard. If you don't get out of rhythm and you're not rebounding and getting easy baskets, every basket's a grinded out, and they played great. I got to give South Florida credit.
Yeah, you talk about grinding it out. Certainly nobody grounded out more tonight than your big fella, Chris Massie.
Well, he's done it all year, and with 3 and 4 guys around him, he's still getting his rebounds, still getting his points, coming up with plays, and that's what's important.
Now, Coach, listen, I know you won't tell me who you want to play the next game, but I assume your staff will be over here watching closely.
They'll watch. It's obvious Louisville's on their home court, so I'd rather play anybody else in the country than Louisville, but they're a great team. They're well coached, and tomorrow, hopefully, we're going to play better and, you know, come out of here and do some damage.
Yeah, Coach, congratulations. Good luck to you. Thanks for stopping by to visit with us. And Mike Gleason, they were in a dogfight here today.
All right, thanks a lot, Reed, to John Calipari and the Memphis Tigers win their 12th straight game. Some close calls in the A-10, the Big East, and the Big Ten. When we come back, we'll step outside Conference USA, check some of the other tournaments around the country after this.
Not quite a stop sign. Yet not a matter to be taken lightly either. No problem. You've come prepared. Plenty of stopping power. And plenty of get up and go. Kelly Tires. A good deal on a great tire. Call 866-90-KELLY.
Back in 1927, we pumped our first gallon of Phillips 66, and word got around we made pretty good gasoline. Our idea was, treat customers like neighbors, because they are, and make sure that Phillips 66 gasoline is always good enough to keep their cars coming back week after week. It was a good idea 75 years ago, and you know what? It still is. Year after year, mile after mile, and for all the miles to come, Phillips 66.
Great devotion to a single purpose. That defines a team. Those who stumble but still find the will to rise up. Risking pain for the chance to stand out from the crowd. And having tasted both victory and defeat, steadily raise expectation. The NCAA Championships on ESPN.
Back in
inside Freedom Hall in Louisville, Kentucky. It's the Kelly Tires 2003 Conference USA Men's Basketball Tournament. Number two, the Memphis Tigers move on. The Bulls of South Florida, after upsetting DePaul, almost pulled off another upset. Didn't quite have enough. 62-56, the final here. Hi, everybody. Welcome back to Studio 66. Alongside Reed Geddes, I'm Mike Gleason. You know, you look at Seth Greenberg. Memphis, South Florida was a one-point game, a seven-point game this year. You look at Seth Greenberg's face as he walked off the floor. It almost felt like he said, we let one slip away here.
Yeah, they did let one slip away. I mean, what absolutely atrocious free throw shooting. You don't even have to shoot great. Just shoot respectable from the line, and Seth Greenberg leaves this court with a completely different look on his face.
And then when John Calipari was talking to you, it looked like the expression on his face, he was not satisfied with his team's play.
He shouldn't have been. They did not start very well. They did a better job, I think, in the second half of executing. But, you know, let's face it, other than Antonio Burks at the end of the game and Carney hitting some free throws, Memphis was just as bad from the free throw line. And these coaches know, if you want to win at this time of the year, you better be able to make some free throws.
All right, let's take a look at some of the action here from game number one. Memphis and South Florida. Dreis steps outside, knocks down a three. Baker. Yusef Baker, the player of the year in Florida last year. Big, big game. Played with a lot of intensity. Will McDonald, the Massie matchup. That was a big one today. Antonio Burks taking it, splitting down the land on the alley-oop. John Carney. Carney, the freshman. And Chris Massie, big second half. He had 7 points in the first half, but Massie played huge in the second half, Reed.
Yeah, I thought it was a big basketball game. You know, Will McDonald on the bench, I thought Memphis would run away with it. Seth Greenberg's squad did a good job staying close with the big man on the bench.
62-56, Tigers move on. South Florida heads back to Tampa as we check the brackets now. So Memphis will now take on the winner of Louisville, Tulane. That game is forthcoming in the next half hour. And, of course, Marquette, UAB coming up later tonight. St. Louis and Southern Miss. Southern Miss, of course, knocking off fifth seed Cincinnati last night.